What for me is very important, and that's also the philosophy I created, is the people, place, purpose and poetry. And for me it's very important to link it to the place. I'm Francine Hoeben, founding partner, creative director of Meccano Architects in the Netherlands, from the Netherlands. And very happy to be here in Shenzhen again. I always say architecture should touch all the senses, feeling it, what is this atmosphere, how do you move through a space with your human body. I also like to create spaces with human values and also create public space and collective space, because what you see nowadays, maybe all happening all over the world, is a kind of loneliness. People are getting more and more lonely and more just being all at themselves. So to create public space where people can meet and can become a community is for me very important, to create that space in urban planning and but also in architecture. We've been working for 12 years on the National Performing Arts Center in Kaohsiung, and I think it's a unique building with a unique public space. It's really made also for the Chinese culture, what is also so informal. It's a concert hall, it's a recital hall, it's an opera house, and it's a playhouse. We put it all under one roof, and where the roof touches the park, it becomes an open-air theater. And I think what is so unique is that all these four auditoria, they all are air-conditioned, but the space in between is like a tropical space. I like it very much that it's named the living room of the city. And we created an acoustic landscape with this Banyan Plaza. So what do? They meet each other, they do yoga in that space, they do Tai Chi, meditation, but there has also been performances that you can see a movie over there or a DJ concert. I have a very good musician, he's a friend who plays the saxophone, and he went playing there. He said this acoustic landscape of that building is so amazing, but you know, the informal and the formal, they come so beautiful together as part of Chinese culture in that building. I've been now researching mobility for 20 years this year, and I always have looked at mobility not like a traffic engineer. I said we should look at mobility as part of daily life from the perspective of a human being. So for instance, that's why we also did the research between the mobility between Shenzhen and Guangzhou and in Beijing, for instance. What I did experience of working here in Asia, in China, it's also quite open-minded and also very innovative. And I think that atmosphere is also very much part of Shenzhen. I think what is extremely interesting about Shenzhen is that it's a new town, and also the change of industry going into more the knowledge industry, what is very much also based here in Shenzhen. So it's extremely interesting, and of course Shenzhen's choose that nature, being green and healthy, is very much part of this city, and you experience that if you compare it to other cities in China. But still, it's still a young child to this city, so it has to grow up and it has to develop itself. I'm also very happy to be a little bit part of this.